Hey, what's going on? It's your boy BT, and I came here to talk some boxing with the thousands of True School Sports subscribers. Now, it was just, you know, I literally just got off my live, and as you can see, I'm shirtless because this fight between Andy Ruiz and Anthony Joshua was so wild, it was so action-packed, it was so dramatic, it was just one of those magical nights in boxing that remind you and really put it into perspective why it is you love the sport, why it is I cover boxing, why it is I enjoy doing what I do. Andy Ruiz, man, just an absolutely exceptional performance. And this video is about him. This video is not about Joshua. It's not about Fury. It's not about Wilder. This video is about Andy Ruiz. And I wanted to say this, man. The performance he delivered tonight was one of the most gutsy, most brilliant, most just well-executed upsets I've ever seen in my life in any sport. And you know, Andy Ruiz Jr. is in the driver's seat of boxing. Like, it's funny because when Anthony Joshua beat Vladimir Klitschko a couple years ago, I came on the next day and I made a video basically talking about how Anthony Joshua is now in the driver's seat of boxing. You know, he can call the shots, he can dictate, he can, you know, do things from a position of strength. And he did for the majority of his heavyweight title run, he did. He fought in the UK, he sold out stadiums there, he came to America, sold a lot of tickets here. So with that being said, man, the same things I said about Joshua in that video, they now apply to Andy Ruiz. And he's in a unique position, Andy Ruiz, because we've never seen a Mexican heavyweight champion. We know that Mexican fighters tend to draw very well here in America because the Mexican fan base supports them. And we know Canelo, particularly here in America, is a pay-per-view phenomenon. He's a pay-per-view star. He is the cash cow boxing. But move out the way, Canelo, because there's a new star in boxing, and his name is Andy Ruiz Jr. Because now he is in the driver's seat of boxing. And how did he get to be in the driver's seat of boxing? By beating the man who was in the driver's seat, another man who was in the driver's seat of boxing in his weight class, in Anthony Joshua. And it was just an absolutely amazing performance. You know, I just got off the phone with my main man Jesse Robinson. And he was telling me about, you know, I interviewed Jesse, and Jesse was telling me in our interview, he said that Andy Ruiz can beat Anthony Joshua, but he's got to be smoking. He's got to be like smoking Joe Frazier. And tonight, he was the Mexican smoking Joe Frazier. He turned in that kind of performance tonight. And he beat up, obliterated, and folded up Anthony Joshua like a steel chair. And he beat a prime, and I must stress this so you guys understand this. He took a prime, A-level, world-class fighter. You can say he was overrated. If you want to say Joshua was overrated, that's your opinion. But what is not an opinion is the fact that this man, Anthony Joshua, he won a world title early in his career, I believe in his 15th pro fight. He unified titles and defended them multiple times against top opposition, the best opposition he could get in the ring. You know, and he had the best body of work at heavyweight, more than Fury, more than Wilder, you know. It doesn't mean he beat better fighters, but he did have overall the best body work in the heavyweight division, and he's been a pro half as long as those guys. So you got to respect AJ, and we're not going to sit here, we're not going to slate him, and we're not going to say that he sucks. Andy Ruiz went in there tonight against a prime A-level fighter at the top of his game, at the peak of his powers, and he folded him up like a steel chair, like them wrestlers before they hit somebody over the head with a chair. He just folded him up, and it was a great performance, man. It was a great performance, and it goes to show you, man. A lot of times you hear these trainers and you hear fighters say, "Well, muscles don't win fights, skills win fights." You've heard me say that. Muscles don't win fights, skills win fights. And tonight, you know, Andy Ruiz Jr. showed that to be very, very true. That if you have the right application of skills, and you have the heart, and you have the desire, and you have the will, that you can beat a guy like Anthony Joshua. And it was one of the greatest upsets in boxing history. It's another modern-day heavyweight classic in the heavyweight division. And just like that, Andy Ruiz is in the driver's seat of boxing. And that's why we love the sport, because you could be a guy like Anthony Joshua. You could seemingly have all the right things going for you, selling out at Wembley Stadium, selling out in Wales, selling tons of tickets for a massive American debut. But then there's always that someone right around the corner lurking. You know, you're fighting a guy on short notice, a fat guy on short notice, and he beats the shit out of you. So, you know, what does Ruiz go from here? Should he give Joshua a rematch? I'll be honest with you, just objectively speaking, I like Joshua. I love what he's done for boxing, not just in the UK, but abroad. You know, just attracted people to the sport. You know, that's probably the one thing I hate about this fight so much. It's not so much that Ruiz won, because I'm happy for Ruiz and I'm happy to see a good upset. I love upsets, but I don't like the fact that now that Joshua lost, people are just gonna say he sucked and write him off. But that's the world we live in. Because this is a man in Joshua who accomplished a lot, who has accomplished a lot in his very young career. This is a man in Joshua who has pretty much, along with Canelo, carried boxing, you know, in terms of bringing people to the sport. He's been one of the guys, one of the flag bearers for boxing. So that can't be taken away from him. That can't be discredited. But now he's in a position where we get a chance to really see how great Anthony Joshua is. And like I told my dad towards the end of our live fight reaction, Anthony Joshua's career starts now. It starts now at this exact point, because it's easy to dominate and do well when things are going your way, when you're selling 80,000 tickets, 90,000 tickets, when you're beating everybody, when you're unifying titles, when you're defending it, knocking everybody out. But how about when somebody punches you in the mouth and folds you up and makes you feel the way you made your opponents feel all those years and fights? So now we're gonna see just how tough and how good Anthony Joshua is. And you know, we talk about the heavyweight boxing greats like Evander Holyfield and Muhammad Ali, these guys that went on to become 3-4-time heavyweight champions. They didn't become 3-4-time heavyweight champions by being undefeated. They had to lose at some point. And it was after the loss, what they did after the loss, that got them the recognition they deserved as some of the greatest heavyweights of all time. So Joshua's career is by no stretch of the imagination over, like social media and a lot of fans will suggest. In fact, I would even say it's just begun. So I'll have a video on Joshua coming out soon, but Andy Ruiz, man, just what an amazing performance. He's in the driver's seat of boxing. I'll be honest with you, he beat Joshua so convincingly and so clearly, I don't want to see a rematch. I'd rather Andy Ruiz go another route, let Joshua build his way back up, fight the Dillian Whites of the world, the Hergovics, you know, whoever doesn't want to put him in there with, he should go another route. Because Andy Ruiz should be afforded the chance to do what he wants to do, because he's now in the driver's seat. The same position Joshua earned when he beat Klitschko, Ruiz now in the position as the heavyweight champion of the world and the Mexican heavyweight champion of the world. So he's Mexican. You know his numbers, his numbers and his ratings are gonna be crazy. You know, I would expect Snickers to call him tomorrow and want to do an endorsement deal with him. You know, because what he pulled off tonight was nothing short of exceptional. And even if Andy Ruiz Jr. never wins another big heavyweight fight again, he has cemented himself in the history books of not just boxing, but heavyweight boxing as a whole. So overall, I'm very happy with tonight's fight. In a way, I kind of leave this fight with Joshua and Ruiz kind of relieved, because, you know, we've been here on YouTube covering Joshua Wilder negotiations for like a year and a half, and I'm just getting sick of them. So I didn't really care which one of them lost. I'm glad one of them lost, so now the heavyweight division can get some new life in it. And we'll see what goes on. We'll see what happens now. But that's my take on Andy Ruiz. He's in the driver's seat of boxing. You know, I love Fury. I still think Fury's the best heavyweight in the world. I put him over Ruiz and Wilder as far as who I think is the best skill-wise and who will win all these fights. But if we're talking about being the A-side, negotiating from a position of strength, Ruiz is a Mexican heavyweight champion. And they gotta do what he says now. So Canelo, move the hell over. There is a new star in boxing, and his name is Andy Ruiz. So big shout out to Andy Ruiz, an amazing performance tonight. Really happy with what I saw. I'll make an Anthony Joshua video right after this, but I just wanted to give Andy Ruiz his props. So there you have it. Let me know what you guys think in the comments down below. What do you want to see Andy Ruiz Jr. next? You know, who you want to see him next? Would you want to see Anthony Joshua rematch? Would you want to see him fight for Undisputed, a PBC Undisputed heavyweight fight between him and Wilder? Would you want to see him fight Fury, or maybe a rematch with Joseph Parker? All of a sudden, Joseph Parker looks pretty damn good, because he beat Andy Ruiz in his fight a couple years ago. Maybe they go that route, because Parker just signed with DAZN. You know, there's a lot of options that could happen with Andy Ruiz, but the heavyweight division has effectively been flipped squarely on its ass. So, you know, there's a lot of firsts tonight. We had a first as far as the first Mexican heavyweight champion, and the first and probably the last shirtless video from True School Sports. So you guys leave your comments down below. Take the time to subscribe, like I say in every single one of these videos. You can love me or you can hate me, but I'm just a kid from Daniel. So until next time, take care, guys. And Viva Mexico. Shout out to Andy Ruiz.